Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him, we thank Him. We seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead. And whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. A bearer, a witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah. And a bearer, a witness that Muhammad is his servant and his last messenger. May Allah's peace and blessing be upon him. Dear viewers, welcome to the best of knowledge. In this series, we speak about the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We call it the best of knowledge because the ulama or the scholars have said that the best of knowledge is the knowledge that will enable you to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be fearful of Him and to be mindful of Him. The knowledge that will enable you to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. And in every episode of this series, we'll be talking about one of Allah's exalted attributes. And we will discuss the impact of this attribute on our lives and how we should conduct ourselves in light of that attribute. And today, inshallah ta'ala, we'll be talking about the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala described Himself to be the oft forgiven and the most merciful. Allah ta'ala said in the Quran, نَبِّ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. O Muhammad, declare to my servants that I am the oft forgiven. I am truly the oft forgiven and the most merciful. And he also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, described himself to be the ever oft forgiven, the ghaffar. Allah ta'ala said, رب السماوات والأرض. Allah Ta'ala is the Lord of the heaven and the earth. وما بينهما. And everything which is in between of them. The heaven and the earth. العزيز الغفار. The Almighty. And the ever oft forgiven. Allah Ta'ala also described Himself to be the oft pardoning. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَفُوٌ قَدِيرٌ. Indeed, Allah is oft pardoning, is the oft pardoning and the owner of power, the all-powerful, تبارك وتقدس. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the peak of excellence of this attribute. He is the oft pardoning and the oft forgiven. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the sound hadith told us about the oath of the shaitan, of Iblis, of the Satan. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the devil has taken an oath. The devil has taken an oath. He said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, by your might and your majesty, I shall continue to beguile and mislead your servants. As long as their souls dwell in them. As long as they are living. He said that, O Allah, by your might and your majesty, I shall continue to beguile and mislead your servants. As long as they are living. And Allah Ta'ala immediately replied to him saying, by my might and my majesty, I shall continue to forgive them. As long as they seek my forgiveness. As long as they ask for my forgiveness. Allah Ta'ala is oft forgiven. If you repent to Allah, if you seek His forgiveness, Allah Ta'ala will forgive you. Allah Ta'ala will repent upon you or on you. And furthermore, Allah Ta'ala will bestow His love upon you. Can you imagine this? You came to Him asking His forgiveness and Allah Ta'ala will bestow His love upon you. Because Allah Ta'ala loves those who repent to Him. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ. Indeed, Allah loves those who constantly repent to Him. وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِرِينَ And he loves those who purify themselves. If you repent to Allah, Allah will love you. Allah will forgive you and He will love you. Furthermore, Allah Ta'ala will be happy, very pleased with your repentance. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam described to us the happiness that Allah Ta'ala will have once you repent to Him. The Nabi of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala is happier or more happier with the repentance of His slave once he repents to Him than one of you would be once he find his camel after he lost it in a wide open land. Imagine that you come across of your camel, once you find the camel after you lost it and you were in a wide open land, in a desert. Imagine a person who's in a desert, in a wide open land, and he's traveling alone, and with him is a camel. He has his own camel. On that camel, he has all of the means of life. His food, his drink, his maps, and so on and so forth. And then that man slept under a tree. He woke up, he found the camel gone. He searched for it, and he couldn't find it. After he lost hope of finding it, he said, let me go back to that tree and sleep under it and wait for death. He slept under the tree and he woke up. He found the camel in front of him. How happy he gonna be? How pleased he will be? Very pleased and very happy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happier with the repentance of his slave than this man once he came across his camel after he had lost it. Allah Ta'ala, why would He be happy with our repentance? Why Allah Ta'ala would be happy of our repentance? Because Allah Ta'ala is the oft forgiven. Because He's the oft forgiven and the ever oft pardoning. Because He's the most merciful. Because Allah Ta'ala doesn't want to punish us. مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ What would benefit Allah Ta'ala if He punishes you? إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ If you were thankful towards Him and if you were believing in Him. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا Allah Ta'ala indeed was the ever appreciative and the all-knower. So Allah Ta'ala be happy and pleased with our repentance. Furthermore, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, out of His forgiveness, out of His mercy, Allah Ta'ala extends His hands by day for those who sin by night to repent to Him. And He extends His hands by night for those who sin by day to repent to Him out of mercy until the sun rises from the west. And that shows how merciful is Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And how forgiven is Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala in the Quran commanded us to repent to Him in many occasions. In one occasion, Allah Ta'ala said, repent to me. O who you believe, repent to me. It is better for you. Repent to me with a sincere repentance. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O who you believe, tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha. Repent to Allah with a sincere repentance. Allah Ta'ala is talking about the believers. He is addressing the believers. He didn't say, Oh, the sinners. He said, oh, the believers. Oh, who you believe, repent to Allah. Because you will repent to Allah Ta'ala not only from your sins, but you repent to Allah Ta'ala also from your own shortcoming. يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحا Oh, who you believe, repent to Allah with a sincere repentance. In another occasion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala linked between repentance and having success in this life. If you want success in this life, then make sure that you always repent to Allah ta'ala. Make sure that you always ask Allah ta'ala for forgiveness. Allah ta'ala said in the Quran, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا And repent to Allah, all of you, all who you believe, أيها المؤمنون لعلكم تفلحون So that you may gain success in this life. If you want success in this life, they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Furthermore, Allah ta'ala in the Quran also said that a person who doesn't repent to him is from the wrongdoers. If you don't repent to Allah ta'ala, then you are from the wrongdoers. If you keep on falling in sins and sins and you don't repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will distance yourself from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَتُبْ And whoever doesn't repent to Allah, فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ Indeed, they are the wrongdoers. Indeed, they are the wrongdoers. How can we benefit from this attribute? And how can we conduct ourselves in light of this attribute? First of all, we need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever we fall in a sin. Allah ta'ala will forgive us. Allah ta'ala will bestow His love upon us. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the sound hadith said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Qudsi hadith said that I treat my slave according to his expectation from me. And then he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya ibn Adam, O son of Adam, as long as you call me with trust in my mercy, I shall forgive you with the greatest of ease. Just seek his forgiveness and he will forgive you. O son of Adam, if your sins extended reaching the horizon, and then you sought my pardon, and then you sought my pardon, I will forgive you with the greatest of ease. O son of Adam, if you came to me with earth full of sins, and you are not associating with me anything in your worship, I will come to you with earth full of forgiveness. What a great reward. What a huge reward. So we should repent to Allah Ta'ala whenever you fall in sins. Also, we shouldn't despair from Allah's mercy. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ O my slaves, don't despair from Allah's mercy. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا Allah forgives all the sins. إِنَّهُ وَالْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ He is the all-forgiven, the most merciful. I ask Allah Ta'ala to increase our iman. I ask Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala to increase our knowledge. And I will see you inshallah Ta'ala soon in the next episode of The Best of Knowledge. Wassalamu alaikum. ورحمة الله وبركاته